apologize. My phone went haywire. Thanks. La luz brilla en la oscuridad y la oscuridad jamás puede
worship and the praise that you deserve, Lord. Oh God, I declare freedom in the minds of the congregation today. Oh Lord, your light shines in the darkness, oh Lord. Oh, and I thank you, Holy Spirit, because there's light here today. Oh, I thank you, God, because we can praise and joy despite our circumstances. Oh, there's breath in our lungs, so we can say, oh, praise your holy name. Hallelujah, we might be going through things, but we're still walking and we're still here. Oh, so we give you the glory that you deserve. Oh, do I have a church that knows how to praise him? Do I have a church that knows how to honor him?
Hay una iglesia que sabe cómo honrarle.
Hallelujah, church, let's lift up the name of Jesus.
Vamos a levantar el nombre de Jesús.
Oh, let's praise the Lord our God.
Vamos a adorar el Dios,
oh,
a nuestro
because
Dios.
He is good.
Porque él es bueno.
And his mercy endures forever.
Y su misericordia es para siempre.
Oh, and even when we stray away.
Y aunque nos vamos lejos.
Oh, he is still faithful.
Él todavía es fiel.
He is still merciful.
Él es misericordioso.
Oh, he is still good.
Él es bueno.
And he still runs after you when you run away. Oh, so let's lift up his name. Hallelujah. Let's give the Lord praise.
Vamos a darle a Dios alabanza.
In Jesus' name we pray.
En el nombre de Jesús.
Amen.
He's good. He's good and a faithful God. Everything. sing it if you know it. Oh, our God is great. Oh, we believe it. Than any other. Our God is He. There's so much power in your tongue. If you declare that this morning, listen to the words you're saying. Our God is greater. And our God is stronger. And God, you are high.
And if our God is for us, then what can stand? And if our God is with us, then what can stand?
And if our God is for us, then what can stand?
And if our God is for us, then what can stand?
And if our God is for us, then what can stand?
And if our God is for us, then what can stand?
And if our God is for us, then what can stand?
And if our God is for us, then what can stand?
And if our God is for us, then what can stand?
And if our God is for us, then what can stand?
And if our God is for us, then what can stand?
And if our God is for us, then what can stand?
And if our God is for us, then what can stand?
And if our God is for us, then what can stand?
And if our God is for us, then what can stand?
And if our God is for us, then what can stand?
And if our God is for us, then what can stand?
And if our God is for us, then what can stand?
And if our God is for us, then what can stand?
And if our God
Establece tu reino. depression is gone right now. All anxiety is gone right now. Every suicidal thought is gone right now. Any spirit that is not of God is gone right now. Somebody in this room right now, you need to declare this over your life, that you are a son or a daughter of the Lord. Come on, somebody needs to open up the mouth and say, I'm a son, I'm a daughter. Say, I have an inheritance. Come on, I've been separated. I've been chosen. Come on, say, I'm a son, I'm a daughter. Come on, can we make that declaration in this house? Come on, can we make that declaration in this house? That you are a son or a daughter of the living God. Of the living God. Of the living God. I'm going to take it a step further. I want to talk to some brave people in the room. Because somebody probably doesn't have the voice to say it. But you have come into the right place. You have come within community. And maybe you can't say it for yourself. Are there any courageous people that will be able to touch somebody next to them? Somebody behind them. And say, you're a son, you're a daughter of the living God. Come on, somebody needs to hear that. Tell them, grab them by the hand. You're a son or a daughter of the living God. Come on, prophesy. Prophesy. Yeah. Come on, tell them. You're a son, you're a daughter. You're a child of the living God. Oh my God, there's a fire in this room right now. I feel a baptism of the Holy Ghost in the room right now. I feel it right now. Yo lo siento ahora. There's a baptism. There's a filling of the Holy Ghost. There's a fire of the Holy Ghost. Come on, Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit. Have your way.
Victory is on the other side.
victory is on the other side.
La victoria está del otro lado.
What you thought was going to take time.
Lo que pensaste que iba a coger tiempo.
What you thought was going to take years.
Lo que pensaste que iba a tomar años.
God is saying, I'm accelerating and watch
me do. Estoy acelerando y mira.
Watch me do.
Mira lo que yo voy a hacer.
I know I say this often.
Yo sé que digo esto frecuentemente.
But I believe, Bridge.
Pero yo creo.
El puente.
El puente.
That salvation is coming to this house like never before.
Viene a esta casa como nunca antes.
And before he saves everybody on the block.
Y aunque antes que él salve todo el mundo en el vecindario.
I want to prophesy to you just like Paul did in Acts chapter 16.
Quiero profetizarle a ustedes como hizo Pablo en Hechos capítulo 16.
That the jailer was with Paul and Silas.
Y el carcelero estaba con Pablo y Silas.
And the Bible says that the jailer gave his life to the Lord.
Y la Biblia dice que el carcelero le dio su vida a Dios.
But look what else the scripture says.
Pero también mira lo que dice la escritura.
It says him and his entire house were saved.
Y dice que él y su casa entera fueron salvos.
Can I tell a family in the room right now?
Le puedo decir una familia en este lugar ahora
that you and your whole house is about to be saved.
Tu casa entera serán salvos.
Pastor, you don't get it.
Pastor, tú no entiendes.
My husband, my wife.
Mi esposo, mi esposa.
They don't even believe in God.
Ni creen en Dios.
That's not my problem.
Eso no es mi problema.
I just want to let you know.
Yo te quiero dejar saber
that you and your whole house is about to be saved. You and your children about to be saved. And if you believe that with us right now, lift up both your hands and say, it shall be done. It shall be done.
Así será.
Así será. It shall be done. Come on, give him your best praise.
Así será.
Así será. Así será. Everybody say,
así será.
Me in my house,
así será.
Así será.
Así será.
Everybody, everybody say it with me. Bibles quickly.
Abran su Biblia rápidamente.
To Joshua chapter 1.
Josué capítulo 1.
We're going to be intentional with our time here.
Vamos a ser intencional con nuestro tiempo aquí.
And there is an anointing in the house.
Hay una unción en la casa.
There's a flow in the house.
Hay un fluir en la casa.
There is something that I hear Genesis chapter 1.
Yo escucho en Génesis capítulo 1.
Resounding in my spirit, Priscilla.
Resonando en mi espíritu, Priscilla.
That the earth was dark and void.
Que la tierra estaba oscura y vacía.
But the spirit was hovering over the waters.
Pero el espíritu de Dios estaba sobre las aguas.
Everything may look dark right now.
Las cosas pueden verse oscura ahora mismo.
But let me encourage you.
Pero déjame animarte.
That the spirit of God is still hovering.
Que el espíritu de Dios todavía está sobre las aguas.
Even in your chaos.
En tu caos.
Sometimes we think God is not in the chaos.
A veces pensamos que Dios no está en el caos.
But you'll be surprised where you'll find him.
Pero te va a sorprender a dónde le encuentras.
Better said, you'll be surprised where he'll find you.
Mejor dicho, te vas a sorprender donde él te encuentra a ti.
That in your chaos.
Que en tu caos.
The spirit of God is hovering.
El espíritu de Dios está sobre.
God, I feel like giving up.
Dios, me siento como darme por vencido.
Don't worry, my spirit is upon you.
No,
I'm hovering. I'm hovering.
Mi espíritu está sobre ti.
Somebody needs to hear this right now.
That
the Holy Spirit is hovering, is hovering. He's hovering, he's hovering.
En las culturas de las iglesias pentecostales.
does work quickly.
Dios trabaja rápidamente.
Sometimes God has to take His time.
Pero a veces Dios tiene que tomar su tiempo.
We expect transformation to happen fast.
Esperamos la transformación que ocurra rápido.
But I believe that we are going through a season.
Pero creo que estamos pasando una temporada.
A donde estamos en las manos del alfarero.
In which we are in the potter's hands.
Y eso toma tiempo.
And this takes time.
If I can put a title to my message.
Si le puedo poner un título al mensaje hoy.
It's gonna take some time.
Va a tomar tiempo.
But it will come to pass.
Pero va a pasar.
Joshua chapter 1.
Josué capítulo 1.
Verse number 2.
Versículo 2.
This is God talking to Joshua.
Este es Dios hablándole a Josué.
Joshua served under Moses.
Josué sirvió bajo Moisés.
He was his number 2.
Él era su número 2.
Joshua was the next generation.
Y Josué era la próxima generación.
Moses did not see the promised land.
Moisés no vio la tierra prometida.
But Joshua was able to walk in it.
Pero Josué pudo caminar.
There are generations that will hear the promise.
Hay generaciones que escucharán la promesa.
And then other generations that will walk in the promise.
Y otras generaciones que caminarán en la promesa.
Can I say it over here?
Lo voy a decir por aquí.
Young lady, you may have not heard the promise.
El joven quizás no ha escuchado la promesa.
But I prophesy to you right now that you will walk in the promises.
Pero te profetizo que vas a caminar en las promesas de Dios.
It's amazing that you still got your Bible open, but tears are coming down your eyes. God says, I'm holding you up this season,
Dios
lady.
Que
my word is going to hold you up.
Mi palabra te va a sostener.
So I'm going to tell you something crazy.
Te voy a decir algo loco.
Keep on crying.
Sigue llorando.
As long as the word is holding you up.
No importa que la palabra te aguante.
So Joshua gets to walk in the promise.
Josué entra la tierra, o entra la promesa.
And Moses could not, and here we get to our text.
Y aquí llegamos a nuestro texto.
Joshua chapter 1 verse 2.
Josué capítulo 1 versículo 2.
Moses, my servant, is dead. Therefore the time has come for you.
Y mi siervo Moisés ha muerto, por lo tanto ha llegado el momento para
ti. Ha llegado para ti. Can we do that one more time?
Yes.
Moses, my servant, is dead.
Mi siervo Moisés ha muerto.
Therefore,
entonces,
the time has come for
el
you.
Momento ha llegado para ti.
Tell somebody next to you it takes time, but it will come to pass.
Dígale a la persona a su lado, toma tiempo, pero va a suceder.
Well, take your seats, take your seats.
Tome sus asientos.
Holy Ghost, help me. Joshua gets to walk in the promise. Moses gets to hear the promise.
Josué camina la promesa y Moisés escucha la promesa.
I'm going to be very intentional for the next couple of minutes.
Voy a ser bien intencional en los próximos minutos.
Because if you know your pastor,
porque si conoces su pastor,
I love to run around. I get excited about the word.
Me gusta correr, me emociono de la palabra.
That's why we took the stairs off of here. There used to be stairs.
Por eso que quitamos las escaleras que estaban aquí.
So, because I'll run down and run up if you let me.
Corre si lo dejan.
But I really want to talk to the church today.
Pero quiero hablarle a la iglesia.
I really want to make you think, and I pray that the word of God convicts us.
Quiero hacerlo pensar y que la palabra de Dios no dé convicción.
I pray that as we communicate, as we articulate,
oro de lo que nos lo hablamos, lo comunicamos,
that you can hear what the Spirit of God is telling us today.
Que tú escuches lo que el Espíritu de Dios nos está diciendo hoy.
And you can and immediate team, you guys can leave that verse up the whole preaching because I'm gonna be going back and forth.
Y puede dejar el versículo ahí que vamos a regresar.
Number one, we see that God is telling Joshua, Moses, my servant Moses is dying.
Número uno, podemos ver que Dios está diciendo a Josué, mi siervo Moisés está muriendo.
Let me give you this introduction quickly.
Le voy a dar esta introducción rápidamente.
This is not a message.
Esto no es un mensaje.
About dishonoring our past.
De deshonrar nuestro pasado.
This is not a message.
Esto no es un mensaje.
About trying to eliminate what the pillars have already put in place.
De tratar de eliminar de lo que los pilares ya pusieron.
Some of you, if not all of us,
algunos de ustedes, quizás todos,
are here because of your mama or your grandmama's prayer.
Están aquí por las oraciones de su abuela o de su mamá.
Can I get somebody to testify?
Que alguien testifique.
That your grandmother prayed for you.
Que
your
tu abuela mother prayed. O tu mamá oró por ti.
Somebody before you prayed for you.
Alguien antes de ti oró por ti.
But in this context, as we read this quickly,
pero en este contexto lo que leemos esto rápidamente,
God is reiterating. He is telling Joshua.
Dios está repitiendo, le está diciendo a Josué.
Moses, my servant, he's gone.
Mi siervo Moisés ha muerto.
there's a season that has passed.
Hay una temporada que ya ha pasado.
I'm gonna give it to you in a comical way, but I want you to spiritualize it.
Se lo voy a dar una forma cómica, pero quiero que lo pongan en una forma espiritual.
Some people, it is like going into summer.
Es como entrar en el verano.
Still trying to dress like winter.
Vistiéndose como estamos en invierno.
So I make a little bit of sense.
¿Hace sentido?
That's like going into winter.
Entrando al invierno.
Trying to dress like summer.
Vestido como estamos en verano.
Some of you do it. People in Allentown be in the winter with shorts and a hoodie. I don't understand.
Algunos de ustedes lo hacen aquí en Allentown, se ponen sweaters con
hoodie.
Shorts, con hoodies.
Yeah, and we don't judge you.
Y no los juzgamos.
But I do question.
Pero me hago preguntas.
And it is to say that Moses is gone.
Es para decir que Moisés ya se ha ido,
but
ya
the
se fue.
Promise is still there.
Pero la promesa todavía está ahí.
All right. I won't do it yet. I'll get to them in a minute. Up there. Yeah. I'll get them. It is to help change our perspective, church.
Es para ayudar a cambiar nuestra perspectiva, iglesia.
That your promise does not lie in the hands of man.
Que tu promesa no está en las manos del hombre.
I'll say it again.
Lo voy a decir otra vez.
What God has for you,
lo que Dios tiene para ti,
does not lay in the hands of man.
No está en las manos del hombre.
Though God uses man,
aunque Dios use al hombre,
to lead us and to guide us,
para lidiarlos, para guiarnos,
your promise,
tu promesa,
is in the hands of God.
Está en las manos de
your
Dios.
Your purpose,
tu propósito,
is in the hands of God.
Está en las manos de Dios.
And it is to say,
y es para decir,
because Joshua was mourning.
Porque Josué estaba mourning. En de luto, thank you.
Because Moses had died.
Porque Moisés había muerto.
I don't want to make it seem like Joshua just wasn't suffering about what just happened.
No quiero que se haga ver como si Josué no estaba sufriendo.
Think of somebody in your life that is a parental figure in your life.
Si hay alguien en tu vida que es una figura paternal en tu vida.
Now imagine them passing away.
Imagínate que ellos fallezcan.
In our humanity.
En nuestra humanidad.
That hurts.
Eso duele.
We're going to cry.
Vamos a llorar.
We're going to let out tears.
Vamos a llorar.
But God is telling Joshua.
Pero Dios está diciendo a Josué.
Moses is gone.
Moisés ya ha muerto.
But the time has come for
Pero el
you.
Tiempo ha llegado para ti.
What is God telling Joshua here?
¿Qué Dios está diciendo a Josué aquí?
What I did with Moses,
lo que yo hice con Moisés,
that time has gone,
ese tiempo ya ha pasado.
But just because you don't see Moses,
y porque no ves a Moisés,
doesn't mean you won't see my hand move over
no
your
quiere
life.
Decir que no va a ver mi mano mover sobre tu vida.
Yeah, so I want to talk to you for a few moments.
Quiero hablarle por unos cuantos momentos.
Because I believe one of the life long questions that we have.
Porque yo creo que una de las preguntas de la vida que tenemos.
What is my purpose?
¿Qué es mi propósito?
What is my purpose?
¿Qué es mi propósito?
In my life.
En mi vida.
I was talking to my mentor yesterday.
Estaba hablando con mi mentor ayer.
Me and him are about the same height, 5'8", 5'9".
You want me to translate that?
Yeah.
Okay.
What's your certificate?
No. Él y mi, I can't even speak, I'm sorry. Mi mentor y yo medimos 5'8", 5'9". Bien alto. Amén.
So, he told me that he played basketball, he played baseball.
Él me dijo que jugaba basquetbol y béisbol.
And he said he was a quarterback in football.
Y él era un quarterback en fútbol.
The guy that throws the ball.
El que tira la pelota.
And he said he couldn't do it anymore.
Y él dijo que no podía hacerlo ya.
Because he couldn't see over the players.
Porque no podía ver sobre los otros, los otros jugadores.
Okay. I promise you. I'm getting somewhere. So as he tells me this story,
en lo que me cuenta esta historia,
he begins to tell me, so I knew that I wasn't going to be a football player.
So yo sabía que yo no iba a ser futbolista.
So I got into ministry. I started.
So yo entré al ministerio.
Why do I share the story? Why is it? And it's funny, I know.
Hey, ¿por qué comparto esta historia? Es chistosa, yo sé.
Because the core of the conversation is, what is my purpose?
Porque el centro de esa conversación es qué es mi propósito.
¿Qué es mi propósito aquí en la tierra?
What is my purpose here on earth?
¿Qué es mi propósito en el reino del Señor?
What is my purpose in the kingdom of the Lord?
Y yo sé que todos nos hemos hecho esa pregunta en nuestra mente.
And I know we have all asked that question in our minds.
Y pasamos nuestra vida haciendo cosas diferentes.
And we go through our lives doing different things.
tratando de averiguar
trying to figure out
qué es mi propósito.
What is my purpose?
Voy a tratar este trabajo.
I'm going to try this job.
Voy a estudiar.
I'm going to study.
Voy a ir al colegio.
I'm going to go to university.
Voy a ir a una escuela y buscar un certificado.
I'm going to go to school and get a certificate.
A tratar de buscar mi propósito.
To try to find my purpose.
Pero déjame de nuevo tratar de ayudar nuestra mente esta mañana.
But let me try to help our minds this morning.
Que nuestro propósito,
that our purpose,
no solamente no está en las manos de hombres.
Not only is it not in the hands of man.
Porque cuando escuchamos esas palabras,
because when we hear those words,
amén,
amen.
Mi propósito no está en hombre.
My purpose is not on man.
Pero tengo otro lado para ti.
But I have another side for you.
Tu propósito tampoco está en tus manos.
Your purpose is also not in your hands.
For the control freaks in the room.
Para la gente que le gusta controlar las cosas aquí.
You have no control over your purpose.
No tienes control sobre tu propósito.
For the people in the balcony.
Para la gente en el balcón.
Thank you. Because our purpose.
Porque nuestro propósito.
Is in the hands of God.
Está en las manos de Dios.
Your purpose.
Tu propósito.
Is in God.
Es en Dios.
And when you're in God,
y cuando estás en Dios,
you'll find your purpose.
Vas a encontrar tu propósito.
And I've shared stories of what I wanted to do in life many times here
yo
at this church.
Yo he compartido historias de lo que yo quería hacer muchas veces en esta iglesia.
I had to learn the hard way.
Y tuve que aprender a la mala.
That no matter what I tried to do,
que no importa lo que yo trate de hacer,
God kept reminding me.
Dios me seguía acordando.
Moses.
Moisés.
Is dead.
Está muerto.
Let me take this a little bit deeper.
Lo voy a llevar aún más profundo.
Because here's I only have 2 points. I promise.
Tengo dos puntos, le prometo.
When we look at our purpose in our hands,
cuando miramos el propósito en nuestras manos,
especially in our society and our culture,
especialmente en nuestra sociedad y nuestra cultura,
we want to do it our way.
Lo queremos hacer de nuestra manera.
We want purpose to fit our logic.
Queremos que el propósito quepa en nuestra mente lógica.
We want our purpose to fit what we have planned.
Queremos que el propósito quepa en lo que ya tenemos planeado.
What do we do?
¿Qué hacemos?
When your plans change.
Cuando tus planes cambian.
What do you do? Because this is another fun question, and I ask it all the time. Where do you see yourself in 5 years?
¿Qué haces? Esta otra pregunta que me gusta preguntar. ¿A dónde te ves en 5 años?
And if you stand or sit here today,
si te paras o te sientas aquí hoy,
is today what you thought was 5 years ago? That did you think that you was going to be here 5 years ago?
Pensabas que iba a estar aquí hace 5 años atrás.
And are there some no's in the house? You're like, no,
hay algunos que dicen que no, ¿verdad?
Some of us said, no, I thought I was going to have a different job.
Yo pensaba que iba a tener un trabajo diferente.
Some of us thought we were going to have more money.
Que íbamos a tener más dinero.
Some of us thought we were going to be living somewhere else.
Que íbamos a estar viviendo en otro lugar.
Some of us thought that we were going to be a whole bunch of other stuff.
Que íbamos a hacer muchas otras cosas.
But your purpose does not lie in your hands.
Pero tu propósito no está en tus manos.
And I've come to remind you because this is my message for you today.
Y he venido a acordarle a ustedes porque este es mi mensaje para ustedes.
That if you trust in the Lord,
que si confías en el Señor,
God will show you your purpose.
Dios te mostrará su propósito.
Here's something that one of my teachers taught me.
Esto es algo que uno de mis maestros me enseñó.
Because when we talk about purpose,
cuando hablamos de propósito,
I really want to dive into this. I'm specifically talking about our sense of purpose.
Quiero entrar en esto. Es nuestro sentido de propósito.
Because I have a gift.
Porque yo tengo un don.
Whether I'm in church or out of church.
Aunque esté en la iglesia o no esté en la iglesia.
For the ones that are real Pentecostal in the room, I want to let you know that I can play piano here and out there.
Para aquellos que son bien pentecostales, yo puedo tocar el piano aquí y afuera.
It's okay. I'm gonna get there.
Voy a llegar.
But my gifting.
Pero mi dones.
Does not give me a sense of purpose.
No me da sentido de propósito.
Yeah, that's good.
My skills.
Mi habilidades. Thank
yes.
You.
Does not give me a sense of purpose.
No me dan un sentido de propósito.
I can be really good at something.
Puedo ser bueno en algo.
But be in the wrong place.
Pero estar en el lugar incorrecto.
Sir. Yes.
Yeah. We could be really, really good at something.
Podemos ser bueno en algo.
But then still feel empty.
Y todavía sentirse vacío.
But then when God finds you.
Pero cuando Dios te encuentra
and puts you in his purpose,
y te pone en su propósito
with the same gift,
con el mismo don,
the sense of purpose changes.
Ese sentido de propósito se cambia.
Oh,
Am I helping somebody?
Estoy ayudando a alguien esta mañana.
So I don't want to talk about just the gifts.
No quiero solamente hablar de los dones.
I really want to talk to you about your sense of purpose.
Quiero hablarte de sentido de propósito.
Because many people go to college.
Porque mucha gente va a la universidad.
They get certificates.
Le dan un certificado.
And they'll have jobs with a lot of money.
Y tienen trabajos con mucho dinero.
But go home and still battle with depression.
Pero van a la casa y todavía lidian con la depresión.
Still go home and still have suicidal thoughts.
Y van a la casa y todavía tienen pensamientos suicida.
Because it's not the money and it's not the gift.
Porque no es el dinero y no son los dones.
It's the sense of purpose.
Es el sentido de propósito.
I remember when me and Tina first got married.
Me acuerdo cuando Pastora Tina y yo nos casamos.
My pride got in the way.
Mi orgullo se metió en el medio.
Because I got to make more money than her.
Porque yo tenía que hacer más dinero que ella.
There's no way that I could be the man of my house.
No puede ser que yo sea el hombre de la casa.
She could be making a penny more than me.
Y ella va a ser un centavo más que yo.
And I want you to hear me, because I don't want the guys to think, oh, cool, I can be lazy. That's wrong too. Don't be lazy. You got a job.
Quiero que me escuchen. No quiero que los hombres digan, oh, yo voy a ser más vago. Eso no quiero decir eso.
Yeah, fellas, say amen to that. Get a
digan
job.
Amen.
Right, Jerry? Give it up for Jerry. That's
yeah,
my boy right there.
Jerry
came
Jerry.
From LCA. There you go. Man. Give it up for my man. I told y'all I was going to do it. I was going to shout you out. And when we talk about sense of purpose, I remember that me and Tina first got married. Hear this out.
Cuando hablamos de sentido de propósito, yo me acuerdo que la pastora Tina y yo nos casamos.
So I changed my job so that we could pay some bills and I can make
y cambié mi trabajo para pagar unos biles y hacer más dinero.
And I remember I was just in a dark place.
Y estaba en un lugar oscuro.
And I came home with probably one of the biggest checks of my life.
Llegué a la casa con uno de los cheques más grandes de mi vida.
But I still felt empty.
Y todavía me sentí vacío.
Because I didn't have a sense of purpose.
Porque no tenía sentido de propósito.
Because I was trying to find purpose in my gifting.
Porque estaba tratando de encontrar propósito en mis dones.
I was trying to find purpose in what I was able to do.
Estaba tratando de encontrar propósito lo que yo podía hacer.
And can I tell you that when it's less of you is when you'll find your purpose.
Cuando es menos de ti es cuando vas a encontrar tu propósito.
When you come to the presence of God.
Cuando entra la presencia de Dios.
And you say, God, less of me.
Cuando tú dices Dios menos de mí.
And more of you.
Y más de ti.
Come on, somebody got to say this with me. Less of me.
Diga menos de mí.
And more of you.
Y más de ti.
I promise you, you're going to find a sense of purpose.
Le prometo que vas a encontrar un sentido de propósito.
Because when you empty yourself in the presence of God,
vacías en la presencia de Dios,
then the only thing that is left,
la única cosa que queda,
is for God to fill you with His purpose.
Es para que Dios te llene con su propósito.
For God to fill you with His joy.
Para que Dios te llene con su gozo.
For God to fill you with security.
Para que Dios te llene con seguridad.
But for God to fill you with righteousness.
Para que Dios te llene con justicia.
I want to preach to you, church. That when it's less of you and it's more of Him, then you'll find a sense of purpose and you'll be able to depend on Him with all your heart, that you'll be able to say, God, I don't want to do what feels right. I don't want to follow my own desires. God, I want to follow your will. I want to follow your plan. And church, when we follow the plan of God,
iglesia, cuando seguimos los planes
you'll
de Dios,
find yourself in His presence and His purpose.
Te vas a encontrar en su presencia y su propósito.
And in His presence,
y en su presencia,
there is fullness of joy.
Hay plenitud de gozo.
Because even within our gifts,
porque aunque tenemos estos dones,
my gifts should always bring me back to Him.
Mis dones me tienen que atraer hacia Él.
My gifts should always bring me back to the Creator.
Mis dones me tienen que atraer hacia al Creador.
Because in the presence,
porque en la presencia,
I'll have a sense of purpose.
Tengo un sentido de propósito.
Joshua, Moses, my servant, is dead. Watch this.
Josué, mi siervo Moisés, ha muerto.
Our loyalty should be on Christ and not on man.
Mi fidelidad debe ser, o mi lealtad debe ser en Dios, no en hombre.
One too many times we find ourselves
muchas veces nos encontramos
more committed to the words of a person in front of you,
más comprometido con las palabras de la persona que te queda delante,
than the word of God that's over you and inside
de
of
la,
you.
De que la palabra de Dios que está sobre ti y dentro de ti.
Yes, God uses men and women to lead us and mentor us.
Dios usa al hombre que te guíe y te dé mentoría.
But there comes a moment.
Pero llega un momento.
That if you depend too much on the people.
Que si depende demasiado en la gente.
That God will have to talk to you like He did to Joshua.
Que Dios te va a tener que hablar como él le habló a Josué.
Let me remind you.
Déjame acordarte.
That Moses is dead.
Que Moisés ha muerto.
But I have something for you.
Pero tengo algo para ti.
Isn't it amazing?
No es maravilloso.
That I still got purpose.
Que todavía tengo propósito.
Even though Moses has died.
Aunque Moisés ha muerto.
Isn't it amazing?
No es maravilloso.
That God has a plan for you and
que
I.
Que Dios tiene planes para ti y para mí.
Even though we feel that there's certain people not in front of us.
Aunque sentimos que hay mucha gente cerca.
Están al lado o a nuestro alrededor. Why is this important?
¿Por qué es esto importante?
Because when this is the core of our life,
porque cuando esto es el centro de nuestras
when
vidas,
this is the core of who we are,
cuando esto es el centro de quién somos,
then we will not depend more on man than we do Jesus.
Entonces no vamos a depender del hombre de, más del hombre de que Jesús.
Watch this. Real purpose.
El verdadero propósito.
I need you to, for those of you taking notes, for real purpose.
Para aquellos que están tomando notas, verdadero propósito.
Is to live for Christ.
Es para vivir para Dios.
Not trying to impress Christ.
No tratando de impresionar a Dios.
I'm gonna say it again.
Lo voy a decir otra vez.
We are trying to impress God.
Estamos tratando de impresionar a Dios.
Instead of living for God.
En vez de vivir para Dios.
That's a sense of purpose.
Es un sentido de propósito.
Because if you keep trying to impress
porque si sigue tratando de impresionar a Dios,
you'll find yourself empty.
Te vas a encontrar vacío.
But when you live for God,
pero cuando vives para Dios,
you will find yourself being emptied and filled over and over
vas
again.
Vas a ver que te vas a vaciar y ser llenado una y otra vez.
Worship team, you can come up here. This is my last point for
el equipo
y'all.
De adoración puede pasar. Este es mi último punto.
Purpose, when we study this and we specifically look at this word in the Greek,
propósito, cuando estudiamos esto y vemos esta palabra en el griego,
we see that purpose literally means preposition.
El propósito significa una preposición.
It is a preposition. It is there already.
Una preposición ya está ahí.
Oh, I hope you're catching this.
Espero que entiendan eso.
This is why we preach that purpose is not in your hands.
Por eso que predicamos que el propósito no está en tus manos.
Because purpose is already there before you.
Que el propósito ya está ahí antes de ti.
Purpose is already there before you even get there.
El propósito ya está ahí antes de tú llegar.
I'll prove it to you.
Te lo voy a probar.
There's a man by the name of Abraham.
Hay un hombre llamado Abraham.
And he had a son named Isaac.
Y tuvo un hijo llamado Isaac.
And God told him, you need to go to the mountain and sacrifice your son.
Y Dios dijo, ve a la montaña y sacrifica tu hijo.
I'll be honest with you.
Y yo voy a ser honesto con ustedes.
If God gives me a baby next week,
si Dios me da un bebé la semana que viene,
come on, worship with me.
Yes.
And God tells me, you got to go to the mountain and kill your baby.
Y Dios me dice, ve a la montaña y mata tu bebé.
You crazy? ¿Estás loco? This is mine.
Esto es mío.
You are out of your mind,
estás,
God.
Estás loco, Dios.
Took me so long to get this.
Me tomó tanto tiempo para tener esto.
Give it to me.
Dámelo.
God, no, seriously. Come on. This is mine.
De verdad, Dios, esto es mío.
I've been praying, people been prophesying.
Está orando y la gente me profetiza.
Give it to me. It's mine. Give me.
Dámelo, que es mío.
Okay.
Está bien.
I'll go to the mountain.
Voy a ir a la montaña.
And I'll give you.
Y te voy a dar.
What you told me I was going to have at the age of 90 something.
Que lo que me iba a dar, que lo que iba a tener en la edad de los 90 años.
Because I trust you.
Porque confío en ti.
And if you're telling me to give you this,
y si me está diciendo que te entregues esto,
that means you got something better.
Entonces tienes algo mejor.
Sometimes we want to hold on to purpose.
A veces queremos aguantarnos del propósito, agarrar el propósito.
This is what God told me to do.
Esto es lo que Dios me dijo que haga.
That's what I'm gonna do. I don't care.
Lo voy a hacer. No me importa.
Come to the mountain.
Ven a la montaña.
And kill it.
Y mátalo.
And what you think is God trying to kill your purpose.
Y lo que tú piensas que Dios está tratando de matar tu propósito.
He's really trying to kill your pride.
Está tratando de matar tu orgullo.
And all along you think he's asking for Isaac.
Y todo el tiempo está pensando que está.
That's good.
Listo, entregalo todo.
God, I'm gonna give you this. This is not fair.
Dios, te voy a entregar esto, no es justo.
And all along,
y todo el tiempo,
there was a ram in the bush.
Un cordero
para él. Purpose.
Propósito.
Was there before Abraham.
Estaba ahí antes que Abraham.
God was just dealing with his heart.
Dios estaba lidiando con su corazón.
To say, God,
cuando estás dispuesto a decir Dios,
I've been studying for 7 years, man.
He estado estudiando por 7 años.
I've been battling through this life.
Estoy batallando con esta batalla.
I should have been somewhere else by now.
Tuviera estado en otro lado ahora mismo.
But I'm gonna give you my heart.
Pero te voy a dar mi corazón.
Because I know you got my purpose.
Porque yo sé que tú tienes mi propósito.
He's gonna tell you.
Él te va a decir.
Pride.
Orgullo.
Is dead.
Está muerto.
Therefore.
Entonces.
I have something for you.
Tengo algo para ti.
So if you're in this room.
Si estás en este lugar.
I wanna do a general call today.
Quiero hacer un llamado general.
I'm not even gonna ask you to come up today.
Ni te voy a pedir que pases.
I just want you to do this with me.
Quiero que hagas esto conmigo.
This gonna hurt, Evelyn.
Va a doler. Pero eso está en tú y Dios. Tienes que ser honesto con Dios.
If you're here in this room,
si estás aquí en este lugar,
and you feel like you're empty,
y te sientes vacío,
you feel like you need a sense of purpose,
necesitas un sentido de propósito.
Maybe God is dealing with your pride, with something in your heart.
Dios está lidiando con tu corazón y el orgullo en tu corazón.
And you need to hear God tell you today.
Y necesitas que Dios te diga hoy.
Let me kill what's trying to kill you.
Déjame matar lo que te está tratando de matarte a ti.
So I can give you purpose.
Para darte propósito.
That's you in the room. I just want you to stand on your feet. I want to pray for you right
quiero
where
you
are.
De pies. Quiero orar por ti, ahí donde estás.
Thank you. Thank you for your honesty. Thank
gracias
you for your
por
courage.
Tu honestidad.
Thank you for your courage.
Y por tu valentía.
Thank you.
Gracias.
Thank you for your courage. Purpose.
Propósito.
Purpose.
Propósito. Porque no tengo otra alternativa.
I got no other choice, God.
No tengo otra alternativa.
So I come to you.
Vengo donde ti.
And I ask you, Lord.
Y te pido, Dios.
To bring us to your first love.
Que nos traigas al primer amor.
Bring us to your purpose.
Tráenos a tu propósito.
That you may inundate us.
Que nos inunde.
With your presence.
Con tu presencia.
With your Holy Spirit.
Con tu Espíritu Santo.
God, this is my prayer.
Dios, esta es mi oración.
That we may begin to produce produce the fruit of the Spirit.
Que produzcamos el fruto del Espíritu.
That we may live by your Spirit.
Que vivamos por tu Espíritu.
That way we can have a sense of purpose.
Para que tengamos un sentido de propósito.
Your purpose is in the hands of God.
Tu propósito está en las manos de Dios.
Your calling is in the hands of God.
Tu llamado está en las manos de Dios.
And I declare this and pray this over your life right now.
Declaro y decreto esto sobre tu vida.
That it's going to take time.
Que va a tomar tiempo.
But it will come to fulfillment.
Pero va a suceder.
The plan and the purpose of God.
El plan y el propósito de Dios.
If you believe that right now,
si tú lo crees ahora mismo,
take 1 minute.
Toma un minuto.
And worship Him how you know how to worship Him.
Y adóralo como tú sabes.
If you want to sing, if you want to clap, whatever you want to do,
si quieres cantar, si quieres aplaudir,
if you want to yell, whatever you want to do,
si quieres gritar, lo que tú quieras hacer,
come on, 1 minute, 1 minute, 1 minute.
Minuto, un minuto.
Talk to God.
Háblale a Dios.
Say thank you.
Dile gracias.
Pray. Say, my
Ora,
purpose
mi propósito
is in you.
Está en ti.
Come on, un minuto.
One minute.
Nadie te está dando prisa. Habla con Dios ahí. Come on, take your time. Yes.
So open up heaven.
Come on, take another minute. It's okay.
Toma
otro minuto. Está bien. Adórale a Él. Give Him your praise. The Holy Spirit is working right now. It's okay. Worship. It's okay. We got time. Worship. Come on, worship. It's okay, you got time. Talk to God. To the kingdom, the calling over your life, the calling over your life will be an influence for those around you. So we're going to make a declaration right now, and it sounds crazy, but this is all we're going to say. We got purpose. We got purpose. Can you say that with us? As you hold your neighbor's hand, say, we got purpose. We got purpose. You're not in this alone. You're not in this alone. open up the doors. We go up to the mountain.
Vamos a la montaña.
Kill what does not belong.
Mata lo que no pertenece.
The time has come.
El tiempo ha llegado.
The time has come, church.
El tiempo ha llegado.
Come on, if you believe that with us.
Si crees eso con nosotros.
Fill this room with some crazy praise right
este
now.
Lugar con, adoración.
Come on, come on, say hallelujah.
Diga hallelujah.
He's a good father. He's a good father. One more time, if you love Jesus, give him your best praise.
Aguas por las tobillos, aguas por la cintura.
And as the Lord fills fills this temple with water.
Y lo que el Señor llena este templo con agua.
He is giving us the purpose.
Él está dando el propósito.
To release the water.
De desatar el agua.
To release the water into the city.
De desatar el agua a la ciudad.
To give life to the trees.
De dar agua o vida a las matas.
Life to the gardens.
A vida a los jardines.
To give life to what's around us.
De vida a lo que está a nuestro alrededor.
You may be asking yourself, what is the water?
Quizás está preguntando qué es el agua.
We are the water.
Nosotros somos el agua.
And as water comes in,
lo que entra el agua,
God is giving us the anointing to release.
Dios está dando la unción para desatar.
I'm going to say it again. As the water comes in,
y lo que entra el agua,
He is giving us the purpose,
él está dando el propósito,
the strength and the anointing,
la fuerza y la unción,
to say go
para decir, ve,
and make disciples. To the ends of the earth.
Hasta los fines de la tierra.
Bridge Church of God.
La iglesia de Dios, el puente.
I need you to get ready.
Necesito que se prepare.
To get filled with water.
Que se llene con agua.
But to be able to open the door.
Pero que pueda abrir las puertas.
And for the water to be released to the city.
Y que el agua sea desatada en la ciudad.
And I dare say to the nations.
Y digo a las naciones.
This is the word of the Lord.
Esta es la palabra del Señor.
Moses, my servant has died.
Moisés,
but therefore the time has come for you to lead my people across the water. For what I am doing in this season. So I speak this over your life. That you are in the right place at the right time. Because the calling of God is about to be released over you. If you receive that, come on, grab your family and say amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
I can't wait for the day that I can be sitting in the front row and I get to see some of you preaching and prophesying up here.
Veo a ustedes profetizando y predicando.
Because there's a release coming to the house.
Es un desate que viene para la casa.
There's a release coming to your life, Josh.
Hay un desate que viene a tu vida, Josh.
There's a release happening over you right now, Josh.
Está pasando ahora mismo, Josh.
There's a release happening over your life right now,
yes,
Josh.
Yes.
And I told you when you came in, there's a release right now. And I'll stop this service right now. Listen, God said, I'll stop everything for you right now, son. He said, I'm stopping everything for you right now. So I speak life over you right now. I speak life over you right now. I need three men to surround him right now. I need three men to surround him right now. Josh, right now, in the name of Jesus, there's a release happening over your life right now. There's a release happening over your life right now. There's a release happening over your life.
Si quieres dar, puedes dar en línea.
We don't take too much time with this. We believe God's blessing us. We're going to keep on moving. I don't know. Amen. So if you got this, the Spirit of God is still moving. Yeah, come up. You come up and give. Come up and give. Quick. Give online. We got a lot of projects going on right now. I want to include this in this prayer. I need you guys to help me pray.
Incluir esto en esta oración.
We still got the believe 100K.
Todavía tenemos el creer 100.
100K. We are still raising that money.
Estamos todavía recaudando esos fondos.
That's helping us pay off the building and to do more projects in the city.
Que nos está ayudando a pagar la hipoteca y hacer más proyectos en esta ciudad.
But last week we applied for a grant, Rosie.
La semana pasada aplicamos por una
beca.
Una beca.
Beca. Una beca. Okay, una beca. And watch this. Somebody say. I told my friend earlier, he's here. I said, this church is crazy. I said, we're crazy.
Le dije a mi amigo ahorita, esta iglesia es loca.
This is how much your pastor applied for.
Yo le voy a decir la cantidad porque apliqué la beca.
I put $80,000 in the application.
Puse $80,000 en la aplicación.
So I wrote it and I'm filling out the application.
Lo escribí, estoy llenando la aplicación.
I wasn't speaking in tongues, it was just me filling it out.
No estaba hablando en lengua, yo estaba llenándolo.
And the Spirit of God says, "You have not because you ask not."
El Espíritu de Dios me dijo, no tienes porque no pides.
So I scrolled back up.
Y volví de nuevo.
And I asked for $800,000.
Y pedí 800,000.
For the full amount.
800,000.
Not for me.
Pastor, 800,000.
Yeah.
Okay. No, I'm making sure I want to translate it right. 800,000.
Because I believe this is a center.
Porque yo creo que es tu centro.
We're going to see mental health counselors.
Vamos a ver consejeros mentales.
We're going to be able to do things for our city.
Vamos a poder hacer cosas por nuestra ciudad.
We have to hire people that need a job.
Poder recaudar gente que necesita trabajo.
So that money, if it comes in,
si entra,
I want you to get ready.
Quiero que se prepare.
Because I don't know what God's going to do in this building.
Porque
we're going to feed.
No sé qué Dios va a hacer en este edificio.
There's going to be a rehab center. We're going to do everything. So lift up the offering.
Levanta la ofrenda.
And help me pray.
Y ayúdame a orar.
Because this is us.
Porque esto es nosotros.
And just say, God, come on, extend your hand this way.
Extiende sus manos hacia acá.
Say, God, it's already done.
Ya está hecho.
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 In the name of Jesus. Bless the finances. Bless the king. This is house. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen and amen. It's already done. Say. It's already done. It's already done. We're almost leaving. We're almost leaving. Everybody, everybody. Say. It's already done.
Hashtag ya está hecho.
Amen. Give me 5 minutes of your time and we're going to leave. Have a quick seat. Brother Steve, if you can switch translating with Sister Jasher, please. It's Sister Wendy. Is Jacob done outside? Can he come in? Yeah, I just need him for 5 minutes. Give me 5 minutes of your time and we're leaving. Because, never mind. I'm going to hold my old jokes in. Amen. God bless you. At this moment, and Jesher, don't go far. I want to invite Sister Jesher Velasquez. Sister Evelyn Vargas.
Nuestra hermana Evelyn Vargas.
Brother Ezekiel Weimer.
Nuestro hermano Ezekiel Weimer.
And Brother Jacob Velasquez.
Nuestro hermano Jacob o Jacob Velasquez.
For a price of 30.
$35. No, I'm kidding. It's free. We're going to have a bucket out there if you want to give for VBS, if you want, if not.
Tenemos un bar de si te quieren dar para algo para la escuela profesional de la Biblia para el verano para los niños.
That's happening in August 14th through the 16th.
Va a ser de agosto 14 al 16.
But if you don't want to get, that's okay. Still take the burger.
Pero si no va a dar, está bien. Como quiera, coge una hamburguesa.
All we ask you is to take a picture and tag the Bridge Church of God and said, I got a burger at the Bridge.
Solo que pide coge una foto de asco. Tuve una hamburguesa en la iglesia de Dios del Puente.
Amen. If we can take this out the way.
Si podemos sacar esto del medio.
It is recognized.
Es reconocido.
It is respected.
Es respetado.
We are in over 190 countries.
Estamos en sobre 190 ciudades, perdón, naciones.
And over 900 million members.
Y más de 900,
I mean, 9 million members.
Más de 9 millones de miembros.
We are blessed.
Somos bendecidos.
For what God is doing.
Por lo que Dios está haciendo.
One of the things that we believe.
En una de las cosas que creemos.
We talked about purpose today.
Hablamos de propósito.
And you, and I'm going to explain what you're watching right now.
Y voy a explicar lo que usted está viendo en este momento.
The calling of God is already over you.
El llamado de Dios ya está sobre su vida.
Whether you get a certificate or not.
Le den un certificado o no.
That does not stop the call of God over your life.
Eso no para el llamado de Dios sobre tu vida.
So that's not what we're doing up here.
Eso no es lo que estamos haciendo aquí arriba.
But we do want to empower you.
Si queremos empoderarlos.
Because in the laws of our government.
En las leyes de nuestro gobierno.
These are the things that help us to walk into places.
Estas son las cosas que nos ayuda a encaminarnos a lugares.
Sister Jojo, these are the things that allow me to walk into hospitals, into prisons.
Esto es lo que nos ayuda a entrar a lugares como hospitales y facilidades.
To affirm what God already did.
Para afirmar lo que ya Dios hizo.
And these four individuals that you see here.
Y estos cuatro individuos que vemos aquí.
Have gone to school.
Han ido a la escuela.
Have dedicated their time.
Han dedicado su tiempo.
They have cried. I don't know how many of you have cried, but one of you had at least had to cry. Stayed up late nights. Maybe had some arguments at the house. Because of the stress. But we believe that God did a work in their life. And they were able to achieve yesterday. Their ministerial credentials through the Church of God.
En las credenciales del ministerio de Iglesia de Dios.
Come on, let's bless the Lord.
Vamos, vamos a bendecirlo. Sentimos amor.
So today officially,
así que hoy oficialmente,
I get to call you Reverend.
Te llamo hoy Reverenda.
Evelyn Vargas.
Evelyn Vargas.
Reverend.
Reverendo.
Ezekiel Weimer.
Ezekiel Weimer.
Reverend.
Reverendo.
Jacob Velázquez.
Jacob Velázquez.
And then Reverend Jester, she already got this. But yesterday she got her ascension.
Pero ayer tuvo una ascensión.
To ordained minister.
A ser una ministro ordenado.
So when you see them at the end of service,
así que cuando lo ven al final del servicio,
you got to do what I do.
Hagan lo que yo hago.
What's going on, Rev?
¿Qué está pasando, Reverendo?
So we're going to pray for them.
Así que vamos a orar.
And with this prayer, we are going to be dismissed.
Y con esta oración seremos despedidos.
But this is my charge to each and every one of you.
Pero este es mi encargo a cada uno de ustedes.
This is not a title.
Esto no es un título.
This is a towel.
Esto es
una toalla.
Una toalla.
To serve.
Para servir
our community,
nuestra comunidad,
and our church.
Y nuestra iglesia.
Just because they have this,
solo porque tengan esto,
doesn't mean that they're not going to clean the church,
no significa que no van a limpiar la iglesia,
that they're not going to be outside
que
serving
no
the community.
Van a estar afuera sirviendo a la comunidad.
But these four individuals,
estos cuatro individuos,
have committed to say pastor,
son permitidos en decir,
they have
pastor,
committed to say pastor,
son, están comprometidos en decir pastor,
let's practice the message, God,
vamos a practicar el mensaje, Dios,
I want to do more. So they are here
así que están aquí
to say that they want to serve more
para decir que quieren servir más.
In whatever area that they need.
En cualquier área que se necesite.
You have been charged.
Han sido encomendados.
To live a life.
De vivir una vida.
To preach the gospel.
De predicar el evangelio.
To correct and rebuke.
De corregir y poder también reprender.
And to be an example.
Y de ser un ejemplo.
To live a life of character.
Vivir una vida de carácter.
To live a life of integrity.
Una vida de integridad.
And to walk a life of holiness according to the holy scriptures.
Vivir una vida en santidad de acuerdo a la palabra, las sagradas escrituras.
Today,
hoy,
we anoint you.
Los ungimos.
In the name of Jesus.
En el nombre de Jesús.
To do more.
Hacer más.
Extend your hand, church.
Extienda su mano.
And let us pray.
Y oremos.
Stand with me. We're going to be done with this.
Con nosotros.
Father, we thank you.
Padre, te damos gracias
because of what you're doing.
Por lo que estás haciendo.
Thank you for the water that's coming in.
Gracias, Señor, por la agua que viene.
And the water that we're releasing.
Y la agua que estamos dando.
This is evidence.
Esto es evidencia
of the harvest.
De, Señor, la cosecha
that you're bringing to this church.
Que estás trayendo a esta iglesia.
Bless them.
Bendícelos.
Lord, bless the families,
Señor,
that are here.
Bendice las familias que están aquí.
God, inundate them with your Holy Spirit.
Dios, inúndanos con tu Espíritu Santo.
That they may go home today.
Que puedan ir a las
that you may guide them,
y que los puedas guiar,
that they may walk in the Spirit,
que puedan caminar en el Espíritu,
and that they may be doers of the word.
Y que puedan ser hacedores de tu palabra.
Jesus, you are the King of our life.
Jesús, tú eres el Rey de nuestra vida.
You are our Savior.
Tú eres nuestro Salvador.
And we submit to you.
Y nos sometemos a ti.
We declare this
lo declaramos
in the name of the Father,
en el nombre del Padre,
Son, and Holy Spirit.
Y Espíritu Santo.
And everybody says,
y todo dice,
Amen.
Amen.